Hi, this is Christopher Boucher, and I'm going to demonstrate when you're working with grouped frequency distributions, how you determine how many classes there will be and the widths of each of the classes. Okay, so let's take a look at this. A study is being conducted in which a variable of interest has 1,000 observations. The minimum value is 200 points, and the maximum is 3,000 points. So our job is to use the 2k greater than or equal to n guideline to determine the minimum number of classes to use in developing a grouped data frequency distribution. So that's a big thing, is that this is grouped. And then the next thing will be, based on the answer above, determine the class width that should be used. And we want to round up to the nearest 100 points. So this rule here, it actually should be 2 exponent k greater than or equal to n. So it's actually 2 exponent k greater than or equal to n. And what this is a rule that's used to determine the number of classes. So let's see how this works. What we do is we want to figure out what value of k needs to be used so that it is greater than or equal to n. And in this case, n is 1,000. So n is 1,000. So we're trying to figure out 2k greater than or equal to 1,000. So what we do is we go and we start incrementing up, and we start taking some guesses. I have a couple of these laid out here. Let's say 2 to the 8th power. It ends up equaling not even close, right? 256. So we have to keep going up until we at least get to 1,000. So 2 to the 9th ends up being only 512. Not enough. So 2 to the 10th, we're getting close, right? It is 1,024. So this is what we're going to use. We don't need to go past this. We're going to use not this value, but we're going to use this right here. 10 groups or 10 classes. Sometimes they call them buckets. So we're going to use 10. So okay, we know that we have 10 classes. The next thing that we're going to do is figure out what the width of these classes or groups is going to be. So we need to determine that. So there's another rule that we can use, and it's this right here. For the class widths, it's W. And then we put down the down here, it's the number of classes. And then the largest value, subtract the smallest. Okay, largest minus smallest, a little messy, but largest minus smallest divided by the number of classes gives us our class widths. So we have a little bit of this data, don't we? So it's like this. We have 10 classes that we've determined. And for our largest data, it is 3,000. And our smallest is 200. So we do 3,000. And subtract 200. Which equals 2,800 divided by 10. Equals about 280. So 280. Now, if we round up, we could leave it at 280, but if we round up to make it kind of nice, rounded hundreds numbers, groups by hundreds, it would be 300. So we would end up having 10 groups or 10 classes that have a range of 300, and that's the class width. The other rule with these things is you don't want to have empty groups. So if we end up having empty groups, that's a problem. And that's where this is a little fuzzy in the world of statistics. There's different ways to do this, and then they say round or don't round. And that's kind of the tricky part. In this case, if we work this out, it appears we would not have empty classes because they say the minimum number is 200. So we'd have something that's at least in the first class from 0 to 300. So we would be good with that without having empty classes. Thank you for watching.